India's Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman announced a slew of measures to boost the sagging Indian economy. The Indian economy, which has for 15 quarters recorded suboptimal low growth, and recently it's been as low as 5%. And that is just not up to the mark, and India is being spoken of as being in a recessionary economy right now. Tax rates were brought down from 30-35% headline numbers to about 22-25%, a substantial reduction for corporates. And that is being spoken about in glowing terms, and the Indian stock market reacted brilliantly. But let's forget about all of that for the time being. Let's talk about the basics. What really is a recession? In any economy, there are two parts. There are the sellers and there are the buyers, the producers and the consumers. And there is a relation between them. Now, when this relationship slows down, when the economic activity slows down, then that is called a recession. And this recession can happen due to two causes. It can happen if the sellers reduce the selling, or if the buyers reduce their consumption or their buying. And let's go over these one by one. Why would the sellers reduce selling? The sellers would reduce selling or producing if they don't have the means to do it. So if they don't have the money to produce goods, to buy raw materials, to pay wages, then they would reduce their production of goods. If they reduce the production of goods, then people would get less money in wages. More people would be out of jobs. The more people that are out of jobs, the less money there would be for the consumer. Because the people working here are the consumers here. They would have less money to buy these products, and the less money they would have to buy these products, the lesser these people would produce, and that would cause a recessionary cycle. And that really is the first way that a recession happens. The second way that a recession happens is when the consumers decide they don't want to consume. They decide that they don't have enough money, or they decide that whatever money they have, they don't want to spend it because something unfortunate is going to happen. Maybe a war is around the corner. Maybe they just don't feel confident enough. And when they reduce their consumption, then the producers, as a result of that, reduce their production, and that leads to the same cycle that we spoke about some time back, right? Now, it is very important for any government to understand which of these two causes is causing that recession. If, for instance, it is the first reason, then they need to aid the producers. If it is the second reason, they need to give money to the consumers. If they get it wrong, right? So, for instance, if this is a consumption-led recession and they start helping the producers and the producers start producing more when the consumers are not consuming, then that creates a problem. There's an overheating of the economy. There's too much produce. On the other hand, if it's a producer-led thing and they start helping the consumer, so there's too much money with the consumer now because of government action, and the consumer start trying to buy goods when the goods are just not being supplied, then that is also a problem, right? Because that there is overheating of the economy and that causes inflation. So if you get it wrong, then there's a problem. And the government here has decided that this one is largely a producer-led or a supply-led inflation. And they've decided to take measures that addresses that side. Now, what have they done? They had two choices. They could either reduce the tax rates on the corporates or reduce the tax rates on individuals like you and I, the personal income tax that we pay. They decided to go with reducing tax rates on the corporates, and this, I think, is the right thing to do. I think the government of India is headed in the right direction. Cutting personal income tax will only lead to short-term demand pickup, and that would lead to an increase in prices. But by taking the supply side route, what the government has done really is they're incentivizing new manufacturing infrastructure creation. They are incentivizing the increasing of risk capital that is available to existing corporates. They are therefore ensuring that more output creation happens, and once more produce happens and there is more money with the corporates, then this gets passed on to other parts of the economy. Let me explain. If you are a corporate, you currently are earning 100 rupees, you are paying 30% tax, that's leaving you with 70 rupees. Now the tax has gone down to 25%. Suddenly after this announcement, you realize that, hey, I'm going to have 5 rupees extra, right? So you're suddenly going to feel a little richer. You're going to use that money to produce more goods. And what is that going to lead to? That is going to lead to not just more production, that is going to lead to more people getting jobs, more people getting wages. And this in turn is going to lead to an increase in consumption, and more people are going to come back and buy those goods that are being produced in the market, right? So What they're saying is, we're not going to cut personal income tax. Just having those people having more money is not going to solve the problem. We're going to make it easier for corporates to produce more, because that is where the problem lies. And I think, like I said earlier, the government of India seems to have got it right this time. So there are two key takeaways from this, as far as I'm concerned. One, I think we Indians love being pushed against the wall, right? Remember 1991? That was such a precarious situation. India was actually auctioning its gold to pay for just the interest rates on the money that we had borrowed. And then the government came in and took a slew of measures, and the rest, as they say, is history. This was not as bad as that, but this was a pretty precarious situation as well. But full marks to the government for coming back so strongly. Remember, there have been two previous rounds before this also where a lot of measures have been taken. But this is a very, very strong move, and I think they need to be lauded for it. The stock markets have reacted brilliantly. One must remember that the stock market is not reflective of the economy per se. Indians tend to be over-obsessed with the stock market. But yes, if the stock market is doing well, then something's got to be right about the whole thing. The second thing, more importantly, this government has often been accused of being heavy-handed. Remember, there is a very thin line between being heavy-handed and between being decisive. This government has been accused of being heavy-handed, going ahead and doing what they want to do without really consulting people. But by doing this, they have proved that they do listen, they do have their ear to the ground. It might take them a few weeks or a few months, but they have come back very, very strongly. This had happened earlier in GST, where the government admitted that there were a few things wrong and revised it over and over and over again. The same thing is happening over here. And this perhaps is the biggest confidence booster that this country and its economy needed. Thank you very much. We'll come back next week with another story. For now, signing off. Thank you.